Hey, do you want some thoughts on what you can do to have more fun on your next trip with your in-laws? Stick around. I've got some good stuff for you. Hey, everybody, I'm Jen Anderson, and I am on a mission to help working Christian moms have more inspiration in all roles of their life, including their work roles, their Christian roles, and in their mom roles. And in today's video, I want to share with you some thoughts about what you can do to have more fun and enjoy those trips that include your in-laws. Listen, ladies, I know that sometimes traveling and being around our in-laws can be a challenging thing. I get it. I understand. I'm on my second marriage, hopefully my last marriage, and with two different sets of in-laws, I have learned a lot about what needs to happen so that I can enjoy my trips more. So in today's video, I want to share with you top things that have made a difference for me to enjoy my trips. So the first thing that I want to share with you is how important it is to have your own space when you're traveling. So for example, about a year ago, my in-laws paid for all of us to stay in this big, beautiful cabin, and we went to Yellowstone, and it was meant to be this wonderful experience. Well, it wasn't so wonderful because I realized that I needed to have alone time for myself, and so did my husband. We needed to be able to break away. And also, it was quite challenging because at the time, our 2-year-old, she was a bit of a struggle, and it was hard because we couldn't really give her the space that she needed. So that's my number one thing, is to make sure that if you're traveling with your family, make sure you have your own space. If it's just your own bedroom in the place, or your own tent, or your own berth on the cabin, or whatever it is, you want to make sure that you have your own space. Also, before I leave on trips, one thing that I love to do is I love to ask Heavenly Father, what's the number one question that I should be pondering in the back of my mind, in my heart, just in my subconscious while I'm on this trip? And so every day when I'm doing my morning spiritual routine, I always ask Heavenly Father, what's the number one question that I should be asking today? Well, instead of just focusing on that for every single day and having a different question while I'm on the trip, I just basically incorporate for the whole time while I'm on the trip. And so I ask Heavenly Father, what's the number one question? And then I write that down in my journal. And then as I have time to reflect and have some pondering time while I'm on the trip, I'll write things down. Or after the trip, I'll take a couple of minutes to stop and think about what were the insights that I gleaned about that question that I was carrying in my heart while I was on the trip. And I also like to look for evidences and information to answer that question, and I write those things down. The third thing that I like to do is I like to look for opportunities to be alone for about 10 to 20 minutes while I'm on the trip. And that's pretty easy because it's small chunks of time that nobody's going to freak out that you're gone for a long period of time. And so for me, in like a normal day, I usually will have a good hour or two throughout the day where I can spend alone and just be alone with my thoughts. That's why I wake up extra early in the morning, so I have my morning spiritual routine. Or sometimes in the evening after my toddler's gone to bed, I'll just find a time to just be alone and have some quiet time. And so, but when you're traveling and you're with all of these people, it's really hard to have alone time. And so you want to look for those opportunities to take about 10 to 20 minutes and be alone. And that's easy because you can just go to the bathroom, right? And have that alone time and nobody's going to question you. But one thing that I caution you is that when you're having that alone time, try to stay off of social media. Instead, just look for an opportunity to be quiet and think and just ponder and have gratitude for the whole experience that you're there and that you have abundance in your life, that you're able to travel. And it's really easy to waste 20 minutes really quickly on Instagram and Facebook, or watching whatever silly videos or something. And so that's not necessarily helpful for you to fill your spiritual cup. Instead, just take a little bit of time to pray during that alone time and just seek to really continue to check in with God, revisit that question that you've brought with you on the trip, and just make sure that you're being intentional about that quiet alone time that you have. The fourth thing is that before I go on a trip, I have started asking for angels to help me. And so what I do is I have a travel committee of angels, and their mission is to help me enjoy the trip, help our family members enjoy the trip, help us to travel safely, to enjoy the time that we're together, and to make sure that we are safe and that we're building good positive memories. And so by basically enlisting my angels, I'm getting help from them to make a difference in my travels, and that makes a huge difference. I just started doing that this year, and man, it makes a big difference for how I'm feeling supported from a spiritual perspective when I'm doing these trips that can otherwise be really emotionally taxing. The fifth thing is that I try to focus on the good as much as I possibly can. And so you might be thinking, okay, is that so hard, just focusing on the good? Well, sometimes when I'm in the crush of all of that stuff with my in-laws, and just people are constantly in my face, and there's just so much that's going on, sometimes it's hard for me to stop and to see the good. And so I'm trying to do that as much as I can, and just to pay attention and to be complimentary and to express gratitude verbally to people, and do the best that I can in those moments to connect with the people that I'm traveling with, the family members that I'm traveling with. And quite honestly, this even applies when I'm traveling with my own family as well, not just my in-laws, but it definitely applies. Just to be gone on a trip and to have that concentrated time with family, where that's very different from in your normal life, where maybe you see them like for Sunday evening dinner, or maybe you get together on a weekday and you go to a park, or you have a pizza night or something on a weeknight. Those are just little moments of time, but when you're on a trip and you're spending multiple days together, it can just feel a lot more concentrated as far as the impact on the energy on you. And then the sixth thing is to focus on the reason for the trip. So you've probably heard the quote, which is that which you focus on expands, right? And so if the whole purpose of the trip is to have bonding time with your family, to go enjoy and to create new memories, keep that as your focus. And so this last trip that I went on with family, we actually went to Capitol Reef. I got myself a cool shirt for Capitol Reef. It's a national park in South Central Utah. I hadn't been there in over a decade, and so I was super excited to go. I actually suggested it to my in-laws and said, "Hey, you guys, let's go. Let's go check that out." And so I was the instigator. I was the one who activated the troops and said, "Hey, let's go on this trip." And so I'm knowing that I was the one who said, "Hey guys, let's go on this," and that I also know that I need to have some alone time and to have some quiet time, I wanted to make sure that I was able to enjoy this trip as much as I could. And so continuing to focus on the whole reason for the trip. And for me, the reason for the trip is to have fun and to enjoy and to go and explore and see new things that are different from what we see in our everyday-to-day life, I mean. And so for me, that was important to stop and to see that. And so one of the things that I do is when I wake up in the morning, when I'm on a trip, is I think about, okay, what is it we've got coming up for today? Because a lot of times it's like you have kind of a general plan for the day. So what's coming up for the day? And then what can I do to focus on why we're doing this trip? And I don't say this out loud to anybody. This is what I'm saying to myself. And then at the end of the day, as I'm going to bed in my prayers, or if I'm laying there in the dark and just kind of meditating and reflecting on the day, then I also think about, okay, what are the things that I saw that are evidences of why we had this trip? And so it helps with the reminding me of the reasons why we're on this trip. And that makes a huge difference, you guys. Oh my gosh, it makes a huge difference. So keep that stuff in mind. So again, have your own space for your sleeping. Allow yourself to have that break and to give yourself that space away. Especially if you have introversion in you, and I am situationally extroverted, but I'm definitely an introvert as well. So I need to have that alone time so that I can recharge. ask Heavenly Father what's the main question you should be pondering when you're on the trip and pay attention to the evidences. Find opportunities to be alone for 10 to 20 minutes every day, maybe a couple of times every day, and that is totally okay. And if you need to let your husband know in advance before you go, let him know, hey, I'm going to be needing some time, a little bit of alone time. So then maybe you can coordinate that with them together, because maybe he even needs some alone time too, and it'll be a great support to him. The fourth thing is to ask for angels to help you on the trip. The fifth thing is to notice all of the good that's going on. And then the sixth thing is to focus on the whole reason why you're going on the trip in the first place, because that what we focus on will expand. And so if your whole reason for going on the trip is to have fun and to have new memories, focus on that, and that's what's going to expand. Instead of you thinking, oh, I really don't want to go on this trip and I'm just doing it, I really don't want to, then that's what you're focusing on, then you're going to get bad stuff back out of it. So those are some of my tips of what you can do to how to have more enjoyment and have more peace and less chaos when you're on a trip with family. Go ahead and like this video. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. I share little nuggets of advice that help us working Christian moms every week, because ladies, we need to have more joy and we need to have more peace and less chaos. And God will guide you and He will give you direction and will help you if we but ask Him. I'll see you next time. Thanks so much. Have a great day.